Del Close said, if we treat each other as if we are geniuses, poets and artists, we have a better chance of becoming that on stage. Good morning, afternoon, good evening, people joining from across the world. Today I'm so excited and so delighted to have my dear friend Sarbjeet joining us in my show of Instagram Inspiration. It's a funny story that we met about 13 years back when we joined the same company, and we met not for the work but for doing a drama. I was the Narad back then. Some people say I'm still the Narad, but that's for another discussion. Good to have you, Sarbjeet.
Thank you so much, Haritosh. Good to see you after a long time. And now that you started talking about Narad, I should give a hint that it was your smile that made me even think that, okay, this guy can play that character. And I think you were one person who was consistent in that role. I mean, yes, it was a different kind of a world. We were in a different ecosystem. Yeah. But then whenever we were coming together for that play, it was binding us in a different way. So the experience was nice. And if you remember, everybody knew us after the show. So that's what art is like. Out of everything, it can actually give you a recognition, give you a flavor to your life, and it always stays in your memory. That's how we connected, and it's great to see you after a long time once again. Thank you so much for inviting.
Thank you so much for accepting the invite. So I'll tell you a bit about the format. This is more like a question answer. I'll be asking a few questions. Mm-hmm. And you'll be able to give your views on that. And in between, anyone in the audience have a question, they can post it on the comment section. And we'll take one or two questions based on time towards the end.
Okay, cool.
So I know a bit about your journey, not a lot. So, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people who are joining or who will watch this video would like to know about your journey from where you started and what all have you done. So would you give us a bit about yourself?
Okay. So when you said about questions, it makes me smile because I have been a person who loves questions until there is no marks attached to it. So, from my childhood, the only thing that bothered me is marks. I loved education. I still appreciate education unless there is a thrust towards getting good marks. I love money unless there is a thrust of only making money. So I always ran behind education. I always ran behind knowledge and passion. I never actually cared about marks and money. But fortunately or unfortunately, marks and money always happened, and they were in the right bucket. And I'm still trying to gain more knowledge, and I'm trying to be a good, passionate person so that I can make a really good project. As you know, that I had a technical education. I was a BTech in computer science. My career graph is good. I worked with you. I started my career with you in a software company. I worked there for a while. I worked in different companies until I realized that I have actually managed to accumulate enough funds for me to take that big leap. But I have always worked in the field of art from childhood. Like I have always participated in plays, and I was exposed to live stage from a very small age. And I should give credit to my schools and my teachers who saw that in me, and they, at a very tender age, they pulled me to that field, and somehow I loved it and I started learning from a very young age. And I started doing theater professionally when I was around 19 or just out of college, when I went to Bangalore and started earning my money. But before that, I had some recognition. I had done a lot of state level, national level work during my college days. from the age group of 12 to 19, I've been doing quite a good amount of work. But when I started doing it professionally, I actually started knowing what I was doing wrong and where I could actually, where that difference comes. So, as I said, I think if you read a very nice, one of my favorite books, it's called Sapiens. It's written by Yuval Noah Harari. So in that, there's a chapter called a chapter about myths. So he says that the smartest animals that that we find today are chimpanzees. Okay, so after that, it's human beings. And chimpanzees live the same kind of lifestyle that we live. But chimpanzees can only control or manage 120 other chimpanzees at a time. Okay. That's what the statistics says, and that's what he puts in his books. But human beings beat them in that that respect. We can manage millions at a time. Okay, that's how our civilization has grown. So the basic difference between chimpanzees and human beings in that respect is myths. A good myth or a good story can actually turn a civilization. So staying being a storyteller is not a bad thing, but the challenge is being in the business of storytelling. So that is where everybody needs to buckle up. Everybody needs to understand how to survive, but a good story always takes you forward, and that attracted me, and that is something that I think always stayed with me. So I just find new ways of telling stories, and the thing that I'm strong at is live theater. So that happens a lot. But yes, I have experience in other camera work too, in other segments too. But live theater is very close to my heart, and I think I'm pretty good at it. So I stick to that for a long time.
I can definitely vouch for that. 13 years back, you were pretty good, so I'm pretty sure you were not hard to make it even better. And I know you also had a flair for singing. You sang, I think you participated in some of the contests as well. So,
yeah, I should admit that I was a good singer when I was in school and all. But that is where I have to bite the reality. I think arts and sports, this is where they are different than any other subject, because like, see, engineering and all, if I talk about engineering and all, we had good days where we have finished a subject in five days or five nights by staying up, and then we have given an exam, and then we have scored a O or A, or and we can meet and go beyond our expectations sometimes, because we know the pattern, or probably we have been studying for a long time. With art, what happens, art and sports, I believe, if there is no discipline, it's like not respecting arts, and when you don't respect art for a long time, it fades away. So that's the same thing happened with my singing, and because I was a good singer, but I didn't ever take trainings. There were many reasons, circumstances where it didn't happen. And when I started taking trainings, I started learning Hindustani classical 4-5 years back. But then I was already involved in theater a lot. Mm-hmm. I was running a production company. I was a director. I was doing plays. So the theater singing training didn't go well. And slowly and steadily, now I feel the difference when you don't really put in that effort. So I would not say that I can be a great professional singer, but I have acquired the quality of performing a musical play on stage, and to that level, I have made myself strong. But I still believe if I would have worked for last 15 years in my singing, I could have become a professional singer. But it's still one of the passions. I would say one of the hobbies which never turned into a passion.
Very nicely put. Okay, and I think let's This is a very good point that you feel. We all can have multiple hobbies, but we can't have multiple passions at one point of time. It will drain you out of your energy. So yeah.
I think if I may add on to that, it's like I believe hobbies are things. Imagine there's a room you have entered. It's a dark room. You have entered that room and somebody has kept a key in your pocket and you know that. Mm-hmm. Okay. That is called hobby. Why? I'll tell you later. The second thing is you have entered the room in a dark room and somebody has said that there is a key somewhere in the room. Okay. Okay. You got to find it and you got to open the room. But you know that the key is not with you. You're sure there mm-hmm. is a key. Okay. And you have entered the room. So that is the difference between hobby and passion. Because with hobby, what happens is you know you have the key and you have that easiness in your body that you can always use it and get out of the room. Okay. Mm-hmm. With passion, mm-hmm. it's not the same. So this is the difference that I have experienced. So if you're passionate, you will drive yourself to survive in that dark room and you will drive yourself to own that room so that it's not the key, it's you who should be the leader inside the room, right? So mm-hmm. So this is a difference that I have felt in last 10 years of my tenure with professionally doing arts and in the business of arts.
Yeah, very, very nicely. And I'm still trying to find my real passion. I am developing many hobbies now, especially with corona, but yeah, let me. Okay. So let me move on to the next segment or next question is where I ask my guest about their encounter with failures. A lot of people try to boast about their success. I am not interested in this show about success. I want to know more about failures. And the reason is that when you encounter failures, you really get some good life lessons. So what have been your one or two failures and what did you learn from that?
Oh, if I talk about failures, then this show will go on for 2 hours. I know. Yeah. I mean, thanks for saying one and two, because I mean, what is life without failures? I mean, you got to fail. Like I failed. I mean, from the day one, failure was a part of my life. Where did you get rejected? Where you have not tried and you have not been successful? It's there. I'll stick to the arts journey because other failures are anyways there in life. You got to get out of it. The first major setback, I would say, when you switch careers, okay, like one career to the other career. See, consistently, I come from a highly educated family. So the mindset of my entire society is like, IIT, IIM, all those doctors, mm-hmm. engineer, high-paying jobs, and like everybody has achieved that. So they will talk in the same tone, and the expectation was the same from me. So consistently, I had to live parallel lives. Like I had to prove something to that society. Plus, I had to keep the fire within me, and that was always a challenge. So I don't know how many times I failed myself and failed them. But when I switched careers, the biggest thing was I was going to a stable and straightforward lifestyle. I was going from a stable and straightforward lifestyle to a unpredictable lifestyle. Okay. Mm. With only passion in my heart. What effects there is, you don't somewhere down the line, the research was not there about the business of storytelling, as I said. So so you get join hands with a lot of random people, you work with a lot of random people, and then you realize that it's eventually the ecosystem has to work to which can take you forward. So that failure really troubles you, because then you start questioning yourself, because you don't know why you're failing. Rather, you because you don't know why you're failing, then you think that you lack something. But slowly and steadily, when you sustain yourself there, you realize that there is an ecosystem that needs to work.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And you got to find that, you got to create that ecosystem, and you got to join hands with the right people who actually listen to you. It's very difficult mm-hmm. to understand each other. Like, I might not be able to understand you fully, but if I'm mm-hmm. respectful towards you, I listen to you, okay, then we mm-hmm. can actually create something, or we can actually, even if we have arguments, it will be more logical. Okay, so that took a while to find that ecosystem, the right kind of people who can listen to each other. When that happened, then there were financial challenges. Okay, because I started a company, I was always inclined to direct and take full control of the art. I didn't have a degree then, but I had a lot of experience, informal experience, and all, mm-hmm. but I didn't have a degree, so initially I didn't get paid jobs anywhere. And in India with theater and all, payment mm-hmm. and money, nobody associates it. But touchwood, so far in theater I have made good money somehow, but that took a lot of time. And when I made that company, I had a very different idea of creating work. Like, I had my visualization. I've always created work which I have read, and which about which I have no clue. I have no visual reference, nothing. It's only in my mind, and I want to create in a certain way. So when you go and pitch in your ideas to people, mm-hmm. I realized that passion is not good enough. Okay, you got to have some skills to actually convince the intellectuals, or convince. So you get a range of people. You get intellectuals. Mm-hmm. You get really, really good people, but they are very few in that ecosystem. You get more pseudo intellectuals and more. Not so intellectuals who want to just do something. Okay.
Yeah.
So over there, managing in between them and convincing a few people to present that idea was a bit challenging. And when you have given, when you have completely switched from one stream to the other, you have two major restrictions: money and time. Okay, because time will not stop for you. Okay, and money will not come suddenly. Money won't come from somewhere. So that impacted me initially, and I also started questioning myself: am I doing the right thing or not? But then, I also made myself believe that I am in water right now. Either I have to swim or I have to drown.
Right.
So that's how I started my company. And even when we I had to, like, initially I had nothing. I was staying in a rented apartment, and that apartment was my rehearsal hall. That's where we all 11 people 12 people started working and creating projects. I cooked for them, I made tea for them, I was the director, I was the butler, I was the cleaner, I was everything. And then I thought, there was a time when I was making 2 lakhs a month, and now suddenly the next month I have acquired this lifestyle. How far will I go? But I'm still alive, I'm healthy, I'm good. So I think I did decent in my life so far. That was one failure that I overcome. The second, I think the major setback that I had is a very technical setback, I would say, is when I came to the US. So far, I have worked with really good production houses. I am assisting professors, drama professors in UVA and in other places. I am working with active artistic directors in Richmond and DC, and learning a lot from them. As I said, I'm more inclined towards direction, so I'm assisting a lot of people. But initially, when you come from India to US, you have a complete different theater interpretation. Mm. So the challenge was, I wanted myself to associate with good people, but then it's very difficult for them to understand a South Asian person doing theater, because people see Indians in two, three different ways, different flavors only in the US. So first, they were very shocked. Second, it was too challenging for me to crack anywhere in the production houses. So I said, let me start auditioning for roles. Okay. Mm-hmm. And the vicinity where I was staying, mm-hmm. over there for the first 4 or 5 months, there were no plays happening. There were a lot of musical shows happening. So musical shows are like singing those, it's musical plays. Like the story will be told in a musical, it's like Broadway and all, which is very fascinating. But I had zero experience in that. I only had, I loved singing and I had experience in acting, but my real interest was directing. So to crack it, I started auditioning for musicals. I got rejected from almost 17 auditions. Okay, one because of my accent. Suddenly, I couldn't change my accent to American or British and all. And I really didn't want to, because I have something unique. I wanted to present that. But then they are also not wrong. Their stories are written keeping their characters in mind. So either they need a Texas character, or they need a Louisiana character, or they need a Carolina character who could sing, who can present the stories. So I got rejected out of from 17 auditions. But people started noticing me because I think I was giving good auditions. So on the 18th one, even though I was rejected, after 20 days or so, the artistic director called me and said, you have it in you. I would like to try. I would like to work with you. And that was a golden moment for me. I said, okay, now there is hope. And by then I have lived in the US for almost 4 or 5 months. I was doing part-time cooking. I was a chef in a Mexican restaurant. I was working at a grocery store for 4 hours. And on weekends, I was driving people around. Like I had a car. Luckily, I had saved some money. I got a car because it's very much required where I stay. So I started doing Lyft and Uber too. Until I crack a project and get a real theater job. And then when I got a call, I went and gave my audition again. I gave many scenes and the director said, I can work with you if you give me your 100%. I said, I have given everything. What is 100%? Let's do it. And then after working with me for 7 days, that is my 7 days of musical training. That's the only training I've gotten in my life. I did Hindustani classical for six, 7 months previously, but that was a musical theater training that I got to read music, to understand and do the play. It was the play's name was Something Afoot, where I was playing the character of a butler, and there was big songs, and I was cast in that play. I was part of a good team. We traveled around different cities and we did around 50 to 55 shows. And that was my break after getting rejected in 17 auditions. And after that, people started recognizing me. I mean, they still see me as a South Asian actor, which I am not. I'm a director. But right now, people are inviting me to assist them. And now when I send my resume, people are reading it. that's a good thing.
So I noticed two very important things in your both your stories. Number one is, as we say in the leadership also, that it's not only about having a good leader, it's also about the whole team. Unless you have a right quorum, right team, you can't succeed. And the second is about consistency. I mean, if you would have backed out after 17 audition, you might have not broken into the great inspiring stories.
I think every artist, it's not about me. If you follow the artist, rejection is part of their life. True. See, rather, I will have less rejections because I am not pushing myself to become an actor, even though I like acting. But for actors, if you see, they get rejected every day. They get rejected, and today's time, it's very easy for people to feel dejected, rejected every second. like, because I'll tell you, in the field of art, the job of an actor and the actor is very helpless unless somebody writes a story, somebody plans to do that story, somebody sets up the equipments and creates the right team. And if somebody does cast that person, then only he can act, right?
Right.
There are people who create content. There are people who create content like holding a selfie camera, making characters and all. But that is not the business of art. That is for your satisfaction. But you can't survive with that, right? So to get into the business of art, you really need a lot of people to manage it for you. So it's very easy for an actor to feel dejected and rejected. But then again, this is a time where they can, this is the only time where you can introspect and work on improving yourself, right? Seeing others work, which you don't generally get to see. See, if you are in one profession, whatever profession it is, the most common thing you'll notice is that we don't see the other colleagues' work at all. Like if you are in the business of software, you code, you never get to see how the other person codes. You never get the good quality of it. You might see from your senior and all, but not from your colleague. The same thing happens with actors, right? They work so much that they don't get to see each other. Like, I don't get to see other directors' work, but now it's a good time. If I get some time, I get to see their work. So these are things for actors. Rejection is part of our life.
All right, I think you already proven part of many improvements. So let me anyways ask you, how are you coping up with the elephant in the room, COVID time, Corona?
I've always seen everything as an act. So like for me, everything is act one, scene one, act one, scene two, act one, scene three, then act two. It's like in plays, in scripts, they say that there's a beginning, there's a middle, and there's an end. Okay. So, and end is basically not happiness. End is basically where everything comes to a closure. That's how I see the end. So, with COVID also the same thing. I'm feeling there was a beginning. There's a middle phase that's going on, and there'll be a closure that will come out. I don't believe in hurrying or being part of a rat race. I have made my choices consciously about how I want to lead my life. So I want to be good at it. So right, this is a time where I am actually working on creating a process for my company, because what happens for theater, there is no definitive process defined. There are good people who do good work and somehow they manage to do good work every time. But it's very easy to fall short when you don't have a process defined. So as leading a company and being in the business of theater and arts and all, I wanted to structure it for my company so that even if I'm not there, and most of the time I'm not there, like I'm away, my team is in India and people are managing without me, even if I'm connected. I wanted to structure out the process. I'm working on that. Plus, a lot of reading. I think there's no excuse to reading and not gaining knowledge of what's happening. Again, there has to be a process of reading. You cannot just read random stuff to sit in my chair. Like when I'm trying to create projects, I think, again, I'm creating that process for my team to follow. I have a very certain taste in creating story. I love sets. I love light design. I'm very much into musical elements to be added in my story. So I want all those logistics to be part of my storytelling. So I'm trying to improve my knowledge in those areas too, even though that's not my specialty. I think this time is too short for me. I wanted this. Because this kind of education should have happened instead of knowing computer science. This kind of education should have happened for me to before I enter into it. But I entered, I jumped into it, and now this is a good time for me to talk to myself and correct myself and bring a process which will help my company flourish. So I'm investing in that, talking to a lot of people, meeting a lot of people. I have a lot of friends who are doctors, nurses, part-time nurses, I would say, who work with doctors, who work in hospitals, who have not been doing anything apart from sticking to hospitals for last 4-5 months. Mm-hmm. I talk to them, get the real picture. I try to stay away from social media as much as possible, and live a life which I always cherish. That's all. Nothing fancy.
Yeah, and I really like that you are making use of the time. I'm pretty sure we might not get such a productive time after this corona. We get a vaccine or anything like that. We might not get to do such a life with the time, and then we are probably gonna miss. So it's the right time to invest in ourselves, discover yourself, and then find out what you are good at, what you're not good at, and then work towards it. So great job. And yeah, and I want to take a moment to actually salute all the healthcare workers across the world who are tolling day in, day out. They're doing an amazing job. Whichever country you're in, they're really doing a great service to whole humanity. And
true that.
Great
true
that. To
true
them.
True that. Everywhere.
It's everywhere. True. Mm-hmm. Okay. So now we are coming towards the last portion where I ask my guests to give some tips about any young professional, in your case, any budding actor, director, or for that matter, any professional. What is that one or two things that you want to give them as an advice which will help them in their career?
Okay, I would say I will only share things that have helped me. Okay, if this helps you, it's great. The first thing that has helped me so far is discipline. Like any other field, you got to be disciplined. You got to define a time. If you write, I can give you examples of writers who define a time of the day and always write something during that time. If you have an idea, always put it down on a piece of paper, because we all have ideas. What we lack is the lack is a structure. Like that, those to-do lists are nice, but to-do list is just to take the thing out from your brain for you to remember. But unless you work on a structure, you can't execute it. So always put down your ideas clearly if you are in the field of art or anywhere, because that is the way others can actually see. Okay, everybody is visual and nobody is that intellectual that they can sense it. And nobody, I can assure you, nobody is good at reading between the lines unless you create something simpler for them. So that is a good thing. There is no excuse to reading. As an artist, I would say, as a human being, you should read. Okay,
yeah.
Because that's a challenging part, watching TV, watching anything, others work, even watching a cookery show when food is being cooked for you. Is easy because you don't actually put in that effort. You just think it's good. Okay, you don't know how much pain goes inside it. But when you read, you go with the writer's flow. You go with the writer's pace, and you can imagine. And there is a kind of work, which makes you more vulnerable to emotions. So if you read, it's always better. Have a structure for reading, and I think. I would personally, have started creating a distance from social medias and online trainings. It's an irony that I am online right now and I'm telling this, but I think everything online is great to get inspired. Okay, but I think taking it as a fact or learning something should be done cautiously. And I personally, I avoid it because there's no credibility to it. There's no credibility to that institution. There's no credibility to that person. Okay. And you basically, as human beings, what we like, we start believing that. Right. Mm-hmm. So if somebody tomorrow says that I will make you a scientist in 7 days, everybody wants to become a scientist in 7 days, right? Everybody wants to be an astronaut. If it would have been easier, everybody would have become. So if you read this tagline that become a scientist in 7 days, that is how YouTube channels sell their work, right? A great tagline. Okay, and you start going into it and you start learning some, like the same thing happens with guitars. If you go to YouTube, there are people who will say, learn guitar in 21 days. Trust me, Haritosh, it took me 8 months to even play a decent Titan song. Okay, because guitar should not be learned with chords. Guitar should be learned first with frets. Okay, but a person who doesn't have credibility, or there are two million people teaching guitar online, will start with A minor, A, D minor chords. So be cautious. I can't say stay away, but be cautious. And I would still say books are better than online materials because they have credibility. It's like if you don't buy medicines from by online doctors, or if somebody says in YouTube that this medicine is good, you will not buy, right? You will go for an FDA approved or a custom approved medicine because that has been thoroughly tested. So the material that you get online are not thoroughly tested, so don't trust them blindly.
Yeah. And I think, this actually reminds me, day before yesterday, somebody shared me a really cute picture of a YouTuber who said how to get a million views in 7 days, and that picture was 3 years old, and this guy had got about 100 views so far. So that was so interesting. Thank you so much. And the irony is this video will also go on YouTube, but not for million views.
Are you able to see me? Sorry, I got disconnected.
The irony is that this video will also go on YouTube, and it might not get bundled.
Oh, I haven't done anything. You know, I always tell people, people call me, as you also did earlier, people misspell my name as Sarabjit. Okay, thinking that I'm a Punjabi. Seeing my title as Das, people call me Shorbojit. Okay, so I'm actually an Odia by birth. So that's the last thing that happens. I start from being a Punjabi to Odia to Bengali to Odia, and I always tell them, I haven't made any name so far. So once the name comes up, you will always realize. So it's okay if we don't get million hits. We'll get those hits. Probably after 10 years, you can look back and say that, okay, we did talk.
Yeah. I mean, my intention is not to get million views or something. My intention is to get to meet my different people who has really inspired me throughout my journey. And this is the 13th episode, and I've loved every one of them. Even if people do not see, I don't care, because I have a good time. People who come, I hope they have a good time, and that's what it is. Even if one person can get inspired, that's more than enough for me.
Where do you get an opportunity to speak about yourself? So I had a great time.
Yeah, thank you so much.
And thank you.
Yeah. I will have to finish this episode.
Of course.
As I say every time, this is not the best time, but let's help each other. And when I say help, it's not always about money. It's also about talking to someone about 5 minutes. It's also about keeping a pet.
I think we should help each other with an intent that we need others more than they need us. So if you start thinking, you will get that mindset. So if I take 30 seconds more in the same platform, as I have told you, I am the artistic director of an organization called Theatre on Your Own. We work in theatre, but in today's time, we have also joined hands with a lot of a non-profit organization who are doing great work on the field, especially in the city of Bengaluru, because that is Bengaluru, India. That is where my hub is. I have some tie-up with few people in Odisha and Bengal also. So in case anybody anywhere in the world wants to help the hungry people, the hungry artists, and the people affected by cyclones and all. And these are the segments where we are helping. So do reach out to us. We have an official mail ID called stagefortoyo@gmail.com. We can actually guide you to the right people. We might not be doing it directly, but because as you can see, I'm in the US right now, I might not be best person mm-hmm. to do it, but we can guide you to the right people, and you can help them, and you can, it will be all transparent because they share everything online. You will see their website, and a lot of theater groups, not only my theater company, a lot of good theater groups are run by highly educated people, okay, mm-hmm. who understand the country, who understand the challenges of the country, and who are actually interested to improve the country and bring it to a level where we can actually truly become Atmanirbhar. Okay, right. So that is where they are working, and they are running theater companies. And you I think all the people who are watching me right now, please do a little bit of research about people working in theater industry, because right now I feel a lot of theater people are doing brilliant work in pushing the country up.
Nice. Yeah. Thank you. And I'll be posting the, whenever I post the link in YouTube and other channels, I will be posting the website and other mm-hmm. Facebook details so that people can reach out to you directly. Thank of you course. So much for coming. It was a pleasure to have you, Sarbjeet, and it was so nice to connect with you. Let's end this episode by, as I say every time, let's keep learning, yeah, keep course. Growing. And keep going out of our comfort zone. This is Haritosh. This was a very, very nice talking with Sarbjeet. I will be back next week with another guest who has inspired me in my life. Take care. Stay safe. Let's keep connected.
Thank you so much, everyone. Thanks, Haritosh.